Our next speaker is Janice Stein from the University of Toronto. Janice is probably well known to many of you, especially if you follow her media appearances, whether it be on television or whether it be in the print media. Janice is director of the Monk Center for International Studies at the University of Toronto. She regularly lectures on conflict management at home and abroad, at venues such as the Center for National Security Studies in Ottawa, and even much more far-flung locations, including the NATO Defense College in Rome, Italy. Janice Stein is probably recently most recognized for what I think was just an essential book, essential reading for all of us who would like to hold an opinion on Canada's role in Afghanistan, the book called and co-authored with Eugene Lang, The Unexpected War, Canada and Kandahar. Janice writes on many things, speaks on many things. One of her current passions is politics, religion, gender, and how they intersect. Janice, the floor is yours.
Thank you very much, Janet, and keep strict time for me, okay? Because I could barely restrain myself this morning when the panel discussion was going on. It was a good thing that my friend Daniel Weinstock was sitting next to me, because I was whispering in his ear, and he kept saying, restrain yourself, behave, you're going to get your chance after lunch. So you need to keep me strictly to the clock here. I want to thank Janet and the Chumir Foundation and all the panelists for a really wonderful, wonderful discussion that was so provocative. Grace, I think, put a very serious issue on the table, which we need to attend to. You know, the FFFs, the food, the films, the festivals are part of our diverse mosaic in this country. But when you map the communities onto income data, unemployment data, you see a picture that we really need to attend to. So all in all, it's just been a wonderful symposium. Let me abuse my prerogatives right at the beginning and make one comment about diversity, which has nothing to do with the talk that Janet asked me to give. In my professional life, I work on global futures and pay attention as best I can to what the world will look like 10 years from now, 15 years from now. And when I think about diversity, I don't have any baggage really with that word other than positive, because from an evolutionary perspective, of course, diversity is just an enormous advantage. The more diverse your ecology, the better your chances of survival, in a very uncertain word. So when Carl told that story about Mark, I was listening very attentively, and I thought, oh, how wonderful, right? What a wonderful story. I hope he doesn't change. I hope, because when I think about identity, we all have multiple identities. We take them off, we put them on. We get better and better at fitting them to the conditions in which we are at any given moment in time. We move back and forth. I describe myself as an immigrant, even though I had one grandmother born in this country, but I have very much an immigrant sensibility. But my grandmother was not able to go back to Russia, right? Whereas many who come to this country now are able to go back, visit, stay, come back, and who we are at any given moment in time. One of the ironies I find is I have many, many Lebanese friends. They were in the news last summer, as you know. And when they're in Lebanon, they're Canadian. And when they're in Canada, they're Lebanese. So this question of when Mark will fully decide he's a Canadian, let's put that off, way off into the future, and hope that everyone grows this capacity to think of themselves wearing many suits of color, depending on where they are in the world and where the world is at any given moment in time. What I want to do in the time I have is have a conversation about women You probably gathered that from my question to the panel this morning. And talk about women from the perspective of religion and rights. Religion is probably the taboo subject in our society. Janet said we need to talk about things that are difficult. If there's a taboo, it's easier, I think, to talk about race in Canada than it is to talk about religion. So let me start with a story that probably summarizes where I'm going to go. My husband teaches at a well-known university in Canada. Don't go look up his biography or I'll blow the cover of the university. The Day of Atonement, which is the holiest day of the year in the Jewish calendar, happened to run into his chair 2 days before and mentioned that he was canceling classes because it was the Day of Atonement. Whereupon his chair said, well, you know, that's really not fair. You Jews, you get all these Jewish holidays, and then you get the Christian ones too. That's just not fair. So my husband said, you know, never thought about that, but you're right. He said, that class that I'm canceling in 2 days, I'm going to reschedule for the 25th of December. The point is obvious, right? That we talk about a secular culture, but how we understand secularism, even in a country like Canada, is very much a function of our history, our culture, our past. And so what I'd like to do in the beginning is just take another look at our understanding of secularism, how intimately connected it is to religion. We can't really have a discussion about secular space unless it is in fact constituted by religion. It makes no sense in the absence of religion. And if religion were not an important part of people's lives, we wouldn't pay any attention to secularism at all. It's striking to me that we are now having this debate in Canada, and I call the debate, I describe the debate a little differently, right? I think of the debate as about religion in society, right? Not about religion and society. If we talk about religion and society, then we're talking about two separate things, two walled-off spaces where we don't migrate back and forth between them. I don't think that's the debate we're having. I think we're having a debate about religion in society. And frankly, the people who are most surprised by this debate are Christians, because this discussion about two spaces is a deeply Christian concept. It is very particular to the Christian religion. It actually, to be honest, makes no sense to a Muslim and makes no sense to a Jew. Makes very little sense to a Hindu. It is a deeply, deeply Christian concept that comes out of a particular set of historical conditions and a particular community. To start with the earliest periods, to go back centuries, 5,000 years, very short period of time, depending on how you think about history. But if you look at the Jewish community, then you look at the Christian community before very recently. It's a very late developer, this concept. And you look at the Muslim community, God, a divine presence, was the explanation for life. The divine explained death. The divine explained victory. The divine explained defeat. The divine explained the cosmos, the beginning and the end of everything. So what we would call theology provided an all-encompassing ordering and an all-encompassing framework for giving meaning to what happened in life. Very, very recently. And that's really the point I want to make.